Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, welcome to the topic of Machine Design 1. In last lecture, we have seen the assumptions which are made and assumptions which are used while doing analysis of curved beams. In today's lecture, we are going to look at some design aspects which are very, very important, very, very crucial as far as curved beams are concerned. So let us begin with it. Design aspects. Guys, when I say design aspects, they all are related with the way design is done, the boundary conditions which are concerned with the design, the parameters, the stress parameter, the strain parameters which we must consider as far as design is concerned. So let us look at few such design parameters which are going to be highly important as far as this particular topic is concerned. Guys, as we know that curved beams, they're different in the manner the centroidal axis and the neutral axis don't coincide. So the lower one I have shown is its neutral axis and the upper one is the centroidal axis. And why this happens? Guys, as we bend something, we know that the mass has a tendency to move towards the larger radius. And that's why the mass is moved towards the larger radius of that particular body. Anyway, so we know that this particular part is already in compression. And this particular part is always in tension or already in tension. So as we are going to apply some load, the effects will also change. If the load acts on this particular object, particular side, that is going to reduce the overall effect of tension. And that is going to induce overall effect of compression. So that is how stresses are varying. Let me recollect quickly what way the stresses are induced or what is the way the variation happens. We know that this is the way the stresses are different as far as curved beams are concerned. Anyway, so how the calculation for stress is done? Now, there is another assumption which is very basic, that the overall stress induced in the body will be a combination of the bending stress as well as the direct stress. And hence, the total stress that is induced inside a curved beam after loading will be the addition of sigma bending and sigma direct. So whenever we are going to perform calculations on this particular kind of structures, we are going to consider both of them. So what are the examples of this particular structures? Only railway sleepers? No, there are many more. For example, crane hooks. If you look at the crane hooks, the way they are loaded, they fall under the category of curved beams because they are already curved, and the loads that act on their body actually act transverse to the axis or neutral axis. The same example we can use for C-clamp. Yes, C-clamps are used to clamp different devices. They are kind of fixtures, right? So in those fixtures or in C-clamps also, the stresses that induce are of this particular nature, the nature of curved beam. So the examples are crane hook, C-clamps, etc. So no doubt that we are going to work on the numerical on crane hook design and numerical on C-clamp design. Let us conclude this topic with the design aspects which we are discussing about. So very first design aspect we have learned is the variation. Yes, that is different. And one more thing is, this is a hyperbolic variation. Of course, we can see this variation in the formula that is used for curved beams. But yes, it is a hyperbolic variation. Second important thing is, I am going to list down some of the boundary conditions that act on the body and some of the boundary conditions that are related with the curved beams. Very first is the load, that is the transverse load. Second important parameter is the area of the cross section. Let's see how area of the cross section is important. Guys, try to understand all these examples which we are discussing about, crane hooks or C-clamps. They can come into various cross sections. The cross sections can be triangular, they can be circular ring, they can be rectangular, they can be trapezoidal. And with the advancements of the manufacturing systems, we can have T sections, I sections, even elliptical sections for crane hooks also. So the cross section area is very important. The next thing is material property, Young's modulus. The next is its yield point or its ultimate point. Now, guys, that depends. If the material that is used for particularly a crane hook, and if the material is elastic, I'll prefer its Young's modulus. But if it is a brittle material, I'll go for its ultimate point. Of course, that we know already. Yield stress. Next is factor of safety, which is indeed very important. And the last parameter, which is quite important, is the stress allowed. Because they will specify either yield stress and FOS, or they'll directly give us allowable stress. So these are the important parameters, design parameters, which I wanted to discuss with you. We will look at these parameters while solving different numericals based on design of curved beams. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to Ekeeda